frightened, Nan?
Oh, thank God you're here. I'm frightened at my life.
Well, it's only a mouse, Nan.
Little bastard didn't get me out of my bag.
Come on, Nan, get down.
I've been stood up here since 7 o'clock this morning.
Are you sure you've seen a mouse, Nan?
Of course I'm sure. It's been up my leg twice. He's torn me tights to pieces.
Well, look, it's all right now. I'm here.
And the attitude of him. Oh, it's unbelievable. As soon as I get into bed at night, he stands outside my door and laughs at me.
Nan, he's not laughing at you.
Not much he ain't. He gets all his little mousy mates round. And they come up here and they slide about on my lino till morning. They think it's a fucking country club. Edith!
Where?
Edith! Edith!
Come on, man.
Oh, I bet he's gone in my kitchen. Greedy little git. He's already gnawed through a box of Ritz. Now, don't get me wrong, they are very Moorish, but you ain't got to eat them up.
Have you put anything down for it?
Yeah, I've put a little mattress down by the stove. Hurry up!
I mean poison.
There's a bucket load of it in there, but he turns his nose up at it. He ain't got any room, see, because he's stuffed his mouth, he guts full of crackers.
No, it's all right, Nan. It's just the post.
What? He's using my address now? He'll be getting me to go and cash his mousy gyno next. What a fucking lip.
Look, there he is.
Oh, where?
Next to the microwave.
He's eyeing up me mint Viscounts. And I'll get in there, son, and sort him out.
I can't use this.
He's been terrorising me for a fortnight. Now, you get in there quick enough if Stephen Gately asked you. Go on, son, get in there before he tears the place apart.
No, Nan.
Now, he's making my nerves bad.
I've done it, Nan.
Did you do it?
Yeah.
Finish?
All done.
Is it gone?
Yeah, I killed it.
You what?
I killed it.
You did what?
I killed the mouse.
You fucking murdering bastard!
But you asked me to.
I only wanted just to shoo it gently on its way. Not pulverize its little mousy brains out.
I thought that's what you wanted.
What, to kill me lovely little Mickey? Where's the only bit of company I had? Be round about this time, we'd be settling in to watch Countdown. I'll throw him a lump of cheese, you wouldn't hear a peep out of him till Emma Day. Oh, I will miss him.
I don't know what to say.
I used to put Radio 2 on in the afternoon and he'd run up and down them curtains. He was a born entertainer.
I'm sorry, Nan.
I'll never be able to look at its cracker in the face again.
I said I'm sorry.
No, it's all right, son. You weren't to know.